Hey everyone, so I'm still broke off from the last video. That hasn't changed, but I recently got surgery on my wrist. So I'm on the way. I should be able to ride like 5 or 6 weeks from now, but by the time this video is out, I'm gonna be riding later in the video. The point of today's video is I ordered these sort of knockoff tubolitos from Alibaba. So they came from China, and here they are. Look like this. They're actually neon green, boys. We're gonna be rocking the neon green tubes in the tires. Yeah, they claim to be 65 grams, which is pretty light, and they're 26s, so they're for the DJ. That's gonna make a huge difference if they actually hold up, but they're super thin. They're like tubolitos, but they came from China, so we'll see if they hold up. Real quick, I also want to point out I got 5 of these tubes, and they're only $5 per tube. And then the only cost you're really paying for at that point is the international shipping, which is why I wanted to try these out, because if they don't end up being good, it's not really like a loss on my end. But tubolitos, on the other hand, are super expensive. I wanted to try out what it would be like to have the lightweight tube, because I hear it's a huge difference in, you know, the rotation weight of your wheels. So they also come with a patch kit, which I was really surprised about. They give you like an alcohol wipe and 2 stickers, so that's actually really surprising. So it ended up coming out to like $60, just so you guys know. And obviously this is not a sponsored video or anything, I just wanted to try these out. So we're gonna throw them on the bike now. Let's get to it.
Okay, I almost entirely forgot to do this, but what would this video be if we didn't actually weigh the tube? So I got a scale right here. We're gonna put it on the scale. 56 grams, so it's not 65. I'm assuming that meant with the packaging. So these are actually 56 grams with the tube itself, so they're actually lighter. Now I have a regular inner tube on the scale. You can see it's 195 grams, so about 4 times the weight of the neon green inner tubes that I'm trying out, which is quite a difference when we're talking about rotational weight on a bike while you're going really fast. All right, we're out here in the garage now. I got the bike right here. I already went ahead and took off the wheels. I'm also gonna switch out, try these Maxxis tires. I got an Icon for the front and a Pace for the back. I've been wanting to try out some different tires for a while now, so I'm gonna go ahead, open these tubes, pump them up, and switch them out with everything.
All right, so I just started opening the tube. I thought it only came with one of those cleaning packets, but it actually came with another one in each tube, I'm pretty sure, so that's really helpful. So that means I have a bunch of these. Here's what the tube looks like. It's literally neon green, which is like sick. Like, I'm gonna be the only one running this. These are super thin, but I'm hoping that this holds up. We're gonna find out in this video. All right, we got the tube. This is what it looks like inflated. It's actually meant for the square bikes that they've been making. Oh, trapezoid. It also fits on the triangle ones as well, but today we're gonna shape it into a circle. All right, I'm sorry for that. I'm just gonna put this on the bike. All right, I just put this on, and this wheel is ridiculously light. I know the tubes don't really make a like direct weight difference when you're picking it up, but I'm just saying, this wheel is ridiculously light. So I imagine things are gonna be a little different, but gotta get the other one on, and then we'll get like a full view of the bike and see what I think. But I don't think it's gonna make a difference until I'm actually riding.
All right, just got both of the wheels back on the bike with the neon green super light tubes in there. Only thing to do now is to ride this thing.
Off to the skate park or some dirt jumps. Not really sure what I'm gonna ride yet, but it will be on this bike, and you will get my final review on how these tubes perform. Hopefully they hold up, and I will tell you if they're worth it or not. We'll be right back. Okay, that's gonna be it for the riding in this video. I've actually been riding the tubes for about 2 weeks before I made this part of the video. My honest review, I like them. I don't really have much to say about them besides that. They haven't given me any problems. I've been running them at 60 PSI. No flats, no blowups or anything. They hold the air fine. They're definitely way lighter. It gives like a sort of floatiness to your bike when you're in the air, I would say. It makes it a lot easier to maneuver. So if you're into that kind of thing, you might like these. Certain tricks like bar spins feel like lighter on the hands. Yeah, I've had plenty of cases and bad landings and they haven't given up on me yet, so I'm not gonna lie, for $5 or $6 a tube, whatever I said earlier in this video, they're pretty good so far. So I'm gonna keep running them, but a little bit on the shorter side of riding in this video. I know I am still getting back into things since I broke my wrist, so yeah, everything's a work in progress right now, but I am happy to be back on the bike. That's all I got. I hope you guys enjoyed. Be sure to leave a like, subscribe, all that stuff that you know, you could do or you cannot do, but it's up to you. That's it for me. See you all in the next one someday when I film another video.